There are two kinds of alkene. One is symmetrical alkene . Another is unsymmetrical alkene. In case of symmetrical alkene, both sp2 hybridized carbon has same groups. So this carbon has R1R2 group, and this also has R1R2 groups. So this is a symmetrical alkene. So in case of symmetrical alkene, both sp2 hybridized carbon had same groups. Now this is an example of unsymmetrical alkene. In this case, sp2 hybridized carbon has different groups. For example, this carbon has R1R2 group and this carbon has R3R4 groups. So this is an example of unsymmetrical alkene. So we can say, in case of unsymmetrical alkene, sp2 hybridized carbons has different group. For example, if I ask you, what kind of alkene this is? So this is an example of symmetrical alkene. And what about this alkene? This is an example of unsymmetrical alkene. Now let us consider addition of HCl on alkene. And first we will consider case of symmetrical alkene. For example, let us say we have this reaction. What will be the product? So in this reaction we have to add HCl over double bond. So let us say we add hydrogen to this carbon and chlorine to this carbon. So we will have this product. Now next time we can do reverse, that is hydrogen is added to this carbon and chlorine is added to this carbon. So in this case, we will have this product. Now if you see, these two products are same. So two products are same. So we can say in case of symmetrical alkene, addition of HCl gives only one product, now let us consider case of unsymmetrical alkene. For example, we have this reaction. What will be the product? So let us add hydrogen to this carbon and chlorine to this carbon. So we will have this product. We can do the different also. Hydrogen to this carbon and chlorine to this carbon. Now in this case, these two products are not same. These two products are different products. So in case of unsymmetrical alkene, addition of HCl gives two different product. Basically in this case one product is major and another product is minor. So one product is major and another is minor. Now which product will be major? This can be decided by Markovnikov rule. And this rule says hydrogen is attached to the carbon. That already has more number of hydrogen. And this product is the major product. For example, in the above case, this carbon has two hydrogen and this carbon has no hydrogen. Basically this carbon has two methyl groups. So hydrogen will go to this carbon. So this product will be major because in this case hydrogen is attached to this carbon. So this is major product and this one is minor product. Let us try some problem. We have this reaction. In this case, hydrogen will go to this carbon because this has two hydrogen. So major product will be. So we have to add hydrogen to this carbon and chlorine to this carbon. So this product is major. Now what will be the major product in this reaction? Now this carbon has one hydrogen, this carbon has no hydrogen. So hydrogen will go to this carbon and chlorine will go to this carbon. So finally we will have this product. Now let us say we have this example. What will be the product? Now in this case, this carbon has one hydrogen and this carbon has no hydrogen. So hydrogen will go to the carbon that already has more number of hydrogen, and chlorine will go to this carbon. So finally we will have this product. So in summary, Markovnikov rule says hydrogen is going to the carbon that already has more carbon. We can say richer becomes richer in terms of hydrogen. And this is the Markovnikov rule.